Sunday's lesson. It says, this is talking about the first couple of centuries after Christ when Christians were being persecuted by various civil governments. Now, why were the Christians being persecuted? I want you to kind of put you in the context here. Were Christians being persecuted in the first century, second century, because they were inciting rebellion, like the Jews who were constantly going to war and trying to throw off the Romans and ultimately led to the destruction of the temple in Jerusalem in AD 70? Is that why Christians were being persecuted?
No.
Because they were inciting rebellion? Were they being persecuted because they were carrying out acts of terrorism? Were they desecrating pagan worship centers and painting graffiti on Roman statues? Were the Christians calling boycotts of Roman businesses? I'm just pointing out that some things that religious organizations and things sometimes do. Christians weren't doing any of this. What were they doing? Preaching Jesus Christ and his methods of love. In an empire, now get your mind around this, Empire of Rome with many gods. Rome had 12 primary gods. In the Roman Empire, 12 primary gods. It's Jupiter, Juno, Mars, Venus, Minerva, Neptune, Ceres, Vulcan, Diana, Bacchus, Mercury, and Vesta. And they also had minor household spirits in the local communities that they would worship to protect their actual homes. And then in addition to those, they eventually accepted Isis, Pan, and Mithras as well. All these different gods are being worshipped in Rome at the time of the first and second century when they're persecuting Christians. So with a culture of so many gods being worshipped, why were Christians being persecuted for introducing a new god? Yes?
It wasn't just a new god, although you know it certainly was that, but they were preaching a new kingdom. They were preaching about God's kingdom, which could have been very threatening.
Okay, specifically how? What kingdom were they preaching? This is why I go back to the questions I asked. Were they preaching a kingdom like the Jews, a civil kingdom of taking over the government, of throwing off the Roman yoke, of rebelling against the civil order? Or in fact, do we find the New Testament just the opposite? Obey the civil order. Be good citizens. So you're right, they were preaching a kingdom, but functionally it wasn't a political kingdom. They were not initiating political antagonism. Do we see anywhere where the apostles or New Testament church sought to get a new governor in Palestine, sought to get different senators elected into the Senate in Rome? We don't see them taking any political action. But you're right. I think what you're saying is very true, but we want to be clear on what it meant. Good point. Other thoughts?
So they were destroying the other 12 gods.
Okay, now you're getting somewhere. So how so? How are they doing that?
Only one true God.
Usurps the 12 gods.
Okay.
And the kingdom is eternal. So it supersedes the earthly kingdom.
Yes.
People aren't getting any more sacrifices for the other gods, so they won't make any money.
Oh, interesting. Now, you know, maybe there was a point here to be made that if enough Christians convert, then all these houses of worship that were charging money to get sacrifices paid. In other words, there's an economy of paganism, and the financial economy of paganism was being threatened. I think that's an interesting insight. There's probably truth in that as well.
Not like we have that today.
No.
Yeah, there's probably truth in that. But also, isn't there a great controversy going on over how many different pictures of God really are there? There's only two. The God that Jesus revealed, and then all the corrupt versions. Now, at their core, we have a God who is love, who creates reality to operate in harmony with his own nature of love. And then we have gods who operate like sinful beings do, who impose rules and threaten you with punishments and have to be bribed or paid off in some way with sacrifices or offerings or appeasements or something to induce them to do good, because they're not really good in their heart. You have to persuade them to be good to you in that circumstance. And every one of the false gods are like this. All the ones I just read in Rome are like this. Christ, though, for God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten Son. This is attacking the very foundation of Satan's government. And thus Satan inspires all of his legions, both human and demonic, to attack the truth. I see a great controversy going on here. Not just, but I think the economic issues were involved. I think Satan played on that. But Christianity presented the God stood in marked contrast with all the others. And Jesus, remember, said, those living in darkness, they don't want to come into the light. Monday's lesson.